Is stem cell therapy for hair loss is effective or not? I tried everything for my hair, like hair transplant, PRP, mesotherapy, and taking multivitamins, etc., but I didn't get any good result. Maybe my hair has gotten worse. I'm a female, 26 years old, and I'm nearly bald. My doctor is suggesting for me the stem cells treatment. So what do you think? Should I go for it?
Thank you for your question. You're 26 years old and you've submitted a photo of which demonstrates significant hair loss and that you've tried many modalities to treat your hair loss, including transplant, as well as mesotherapy, injections, multivitamins, etc. Well, as a 26-year-old female with very diffuse hair loss, I would ask if that you have first a proper diagnosis as to the cause of your hair loss. Female pattern hair loss, which is accounts for 95%, when you talk about hair loss, 95% of hair loss is either male pattern or female pattern hair loss. Now, within female pattern hair loss, there are statistics such as 30% of women under the age of 50 having hair loss, and compared to 50% of women over the age of 50. And female hair loss is very much an area that is really not paid that much attention to, I suspect, basically because there really isn't one good single solution. You've asked about stem cell therapy. Well, we are in a very, I think you can learn a lot from our experience. We've been in a very unique position. Our practice has developed a method of hair loss treatment called hair regeneration, which we use for male pattern, female pattern hair loss, as well as unusual situations such as alopecia areata, systemic lupus erythematosus, and other autoimmune diagnoses. However, one of the things that I would do for a person in your situation when they'd come to us, if you had not gotten a biopsy, then it's very important that at a minimum we do several points of in the scalp of biopsies. We actually send our pathology to samples to a very respected university pathology department to be sure that we have a correct diagnosis. Even with our hair regeneration treatment, which is a combination of extracellular matrix designed originally for wound healing, which is derived from pig bladder, and combining that with platelet-rich plasma, we have in rough numbers overall, when it comes to male pattern hair loss, we have close to 100%, you know, 99.9% success rate of benefit. Female pattern hair loss, around 70 to 80%. And with alopecia areata, lupus, and things like that, we have more of like a 50% rate of success. There are certain conditions, however, that we cannot treat with this stem cell-based therapy, which includes scarring type of alopecia. These are conditions such as lichen planopilaris. So if you have not had a biopsy, then biopsy would be the first thing that I would recommend, and biopsy read by a very experienced pathologist familiar with hair. I mean, not every pathologist looks at hair just like any other specialization in medicine. So the most common diagnosis in hair loss is androgenetic alopecia. So once a diagnosis has been confirmed, then we would then proceed with options for treatment to try to regenerate. A lot of our patients come to us, and when we see miniaturization, which is the hair is slowly thinning, where they go from thicker hair to thinner hair, then we tend to call that some variation of an androgenetic alopecia. So those types of alopecia tend to respond to hair regeneration treatment. The term stem cell therapy is very used, overused and abused, and a lot of people who offer it are basically offering a questionable treatment to very desperate people. So it's very important that you do your research and you understand what it means to have stem cell therapy. We have heard people claiming stem cells derived from plants that are being injected, and other people are doing things such as deriving stem cells after doing liposuction. Certainly there is some legitimacy to that. There's actually been a study where placing fat under the scalp derived from liposuction actually helped with hair growth. I think it has to do with some relation to the stem cells and growth factors necessary to initiate hair growth, but that's a discussion that's outside the scope of this question. So, I think the take-home message is proper diagnosis and then consider proper treatment. Hair regeneration, that what we offer is something that you can learn about and learn the concepts about and decide if this is something worth pursuing and finding a provider who can offer that in an area that might be convenient for you. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck and thank you for your question.